To solve systems with three variables, we must eliminate the same twice, or the same variable twice. This will give us two equations with two variables we can then solve for. In example one, I'm going to label my three equations as 1, 2, and 3. I'm then going to take 1 and 2 and add them together. This will give me 5x minus 9y is equal to 51. I'm then going to take 2 and 3 and add those together. When I do this, I get negative 3x minus 18y is equal to 63. I'm going to call these new equations A and B. A is going to be multiplied by a negative 2 so that I can get negative 10x plus 18y equals negative 102. And B is going to remain the same. I'll just leave it the way it is, and it'll remain negative 3x minus 18y equals 63. From here, I'll add A and B together, and I'll get negative 13x equals negative 39. Dividing by negative 13 on both sides, I get x is equal to 3. Now that I have x, I'll plug it back into A. I'm going to call this an A substitution. Remember, I'm not substituting A so much as I'm just substituting x in as a variable. So now I'll have negative 10 times 3. Hold that. I'm going to just plug it into A, not negative 2 times A. 5x minus 9y equals 51. So now when x is equal to 3, I'll have 5 times 3 minus 9y is equal to 51. 15 minus 9y equals 51. Subtracting 15 from both sides, we get negative 9y is equal to 36. Dividing by negative 9, we get y is equal to negative 4. Now we have the value for x and y, and we can take that and plug x and y into our equation number 1. Substituting again, we know that the original was 3x minus 3y plus 5z is equal to 16. Because of this, we can take the values for x and the values for y plus 5z equals 16 and solve for z. This will give us 9 plus 12 plus 5z is equal to 16. Adding 9 and 12 together, we get 21 plus 5z is equal to 16. Subtracting 21 from both sides gives us 5z is equal to negative 5. Dividing by 5, we get z is equal to negative 1. Our coordinate point, then, is x, y, z, or 3, negative 4, negative 1. In example 2, we'll follow the same process. Labeling, we're going to pick 1 and 2. This gives us negative x plus 2y plus 4z equals negative 20. And negative 2x minus 2y minus 3z is equal to 5. I'm also going to use 1 and 3 for my other combination. This will be negative x plus 2y plus 4z is equal to negative 20, and 4x minus 2y minus 2z is equal to 26. This gives me negative 3x plus z is equal to negative 15. And on the other side, 3x plus 2z is equal to 6. We're going to label these A and B. Taking A and B and adding them together, we have negative 3x plus z is equal to negative 15, and 3x plus 2z is equal to 6. Adding together, we get 3z is equal to negative 9. Dividing by 3, we get z is equal to negative 3. Now that we have z, we're going to take that value and substitute it into our A equation. This will be negative 3x plus a negative 3, which will give us a negative 3x minus 3 equals negative 15. Adding 3 to both sides gives us negative 3x is equal to negative 12. Dividing by negative 3, we get x is equal to 4. Now we have two of our variables solved for. Now that we have two variables solved for, I'm going to substitute x and z into equation 1. This is negative x plus 2y plus 4z is equal to negative 20. Substituting in the 4, get negative 4 plus 2 times y plus 4 times negative 3 equals negative 20. This gives me negative 4 plus 2y minus 12 equals negative 20. Adding like terms, I have 2y minus 16 is equal to negative 20. Adding 16 to both sides gives me 2y is equal to negative 4. Dividing by 2 on both sides, I get y is equal to negative 2. So my coordinate point is negative 3, 4. Pause. They have to be in order from x to z. So 4, negative 2, and negative 3.